will study about nutrition in plants. So what do we understand when we say nutrition in plants? Okay, Arna, can you tell me what do you understand by nutrition in plants?
It means that their growth and what all do they need for them to grow.
Okay. Anybody else? Delisha, do you want to give it a try? What do you mean by nutrition in plants?
Ma'am, I think nutrition in plants means that when you are giving the nutrients and when they also give us nutrients to survive. Because without food, we cannot survive.
Correct. Okay, Vansh, maybe Pranay Kumar must have joined in listen only mode. Okay. So nutrition is basically, a process which is not only needed for plants, but it is needed for each and every living organism. So as I was discussing, that nutrition is something which is very important, not only for plants, not only for animals, but also for each and every living organism, right? Because from nutrition, we derive, certain things for which we can survive, and we also gain energy from it, correct? So we will be covering all these objectives, we will be covering all these concepts and the topics today, right? So to start off with, first and foremost, we will understand what is nutrition. As I said, each and every living organism requires nutrition, So basically, nutrition is a process. It is a process. Matlab, this is a tarika. It is a way of providing or obtaining the food necessary for health and growth. There are two portions to it, health as well as growth. Just imagine if one was missing, if growth was not happening and only health was there. Matlab, we would have just become healthier and healthier, fatter, our organs would have been fine and healthy, but growth nahi hota. We wouldn't have grown taller. We wouldn't have, picked up height. Our organs wouldn't have grown up, wouldn't have become bigger, right? So nutrition is a process of providing or obtaining the food. From where do we get the energy, health and growth? We get it from food that we eat. All of you just said, that somebody likes biryani, somebody likes paneer, somebody likes aloo curry, somebody likes ice cream, chow mein, I love egg roll. So these are the food from where we derive the necessary nutrients. It is a process, correct?
Also for fighting off diseases.
Yes, correct. To ward off diseases so that we do not have any diseases. That's the reason why we mentioned the word health. Health means good health, so that we do not have diseases. Right? Now going to the next slide, why do you think we need food? Delisha, just answer. Why do you think we need food?
Ma'am, we need food to survive.
Of course, we need for survival. What else? What else comes into your mind?
Ma'am, food helps us give energy and it has so many nutrients which help us in growing well and protect us from diseases.
Correct. Very well said, Delisha. Thank you. Thank you. Very well said. You've almost covered most of the points. Thank you. So basically, we need food not only for taste. It's not that, wow, I can have the biryani. It's just not for the taste. It is for many other things. It is basically the only main meal for survival of every living organism. Correct? I'm sure all of you must have studied in your classes, earlier classes 5 and 6, that food contains carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals, which are important nutrients. So from where do we get these nutrients? We get it from the food that we eat. Correct. So basically, from food, we get carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. Right. Now, coming to a very important point, I would want Karthik to answer this. Who do you think are producers? Karthik?
Ma'am, producers are also known as autotrophs.
Basically, what are producers? You must have studied in class 5. What do you mean by
Ma'am,
producers?
those who make their own food.
Very good. Those who make their own food. Very good. Very good. These are organisms. You know, it's not only plants, but there are many other microscopic organisms also which make their own food. They are producing food, you know. This is what, you know, it is very self-explanatory. They produce their own food. Correct? Now, Khushi, tell me, what do you mean by consumers then? Who are consumers then?
Ma'am, may I tell?
Khushi, please. Khushi?
Ma'am, consumers are those organisms who eat other decayed material or...
Yes, partially correct. They not only eat decayed materials, but basically consumers are organisms which depend on other organisms for their food, right? So if we say human beings are consumers, animals, most of the animals are consumers because they are depending. They are depending on other plants or animals for their food. They cannot make their own food. They only consume. They cannot produce. They only consume the food. That's why they are called as consumers. Correct? Yes, Khushi, you're right. Also because the producers have chlorophyll. They can produce their own food. Correct, you're right. So plants, as we have studied, is, you know, in earlier classes, they can make their own food. Correct? Whereas animals and human beings, they depend on plants and animals for their food. For example, you know, if there is a, maybe an apple tree, you know, the apple tree, the leaves can be had by cow or goats, right? Again, maybe, you know, a tiger can have a goat. A crocodile in turn will have the tiger, right? A crocodile can be had, you know, there are human beings who have crocodile meat. So, you know, this is like a long chain. We also call it a food chain. So basically, the original food actually came from the plants, the apple tree, the leaves of the apple tree, which has chlorophyll and can produce its own food. So it's a producer. And from the goat and the tiger and everything onwards, they're all consumers. None of them can make their own food. They have to be dependent on other plants or animals for their own nutrition. Correct? Till here, are we all on the same page? Okay, great.